Welcome to numerologist.com. It's me, Vannessa, from Beyond Your Sun Sign. This is your tarot card reading for December 7th to December 14th. Let's get started. Okay, so as always, we want to take a deep breath in and exhale. Now we're thinking of a number between 1 and 3. 1, 2, or 3. Okay, if you chose card number 1, we have the 5 of Pentacles. So, of course, now with Christmas around the corner, holidays gearing up, we're feeling really trapped when it comes to our finances. Almost feeling a little bit like a charity case, looking around like, who's going to help me this year with everything I have going on, especially financially? And that's really great to kind of be looking around saying, who can help? Because really the universe will be answering that call through some sort of Christmas miracle, as long as you expect it and anticipate it, right? It's all about saying, yeah, this is typically a crazy time, a really expensive time. It really is an excellent time to look at your belief systems surrounding money as well, right? What was your Christmas like growing up? Did you have an abundance of gifts, but you realized that after January 1st, your parents were really stressed about money, so they went all out and they kind of screwed themselves over in the long run. Maybe Christmas was all about, you know, that big present from Santa, and now when you're older, you're a little bit more resentful, being like, okay, where's that big fat guy that's going to give me, you know, my rent next month? Things like that were kind of looking for those handouts, looking for those charity cases, and now is the time to give back and just give it out there. Even if it's your last $10, put it out there, and then the universe will be like, okay, I'm going to give you more abundance. I'm going to really give you that Christmas miracle. Here is the abundance that you put out coming back to you times 3. So if you're feeling this crunch this holiday season, put money out. There's always going to be somebody who's less fortunate than you. So give to that person. I'm not talking about family. I'm not talking about friends. I'm talking about a complete stranger that can't look at you and be like, well, are you sure you can afford this? You know, are you sure you should be doing this? Aren't you the one that needs the help? A stranger who will look at you and be like, wow, what an abundant person, without knowing your history. And then they're going to manifest for you as well, looking at you, be like, that person must be really abundant. And then it comes back. You have that double energy coming back to you times 10. Okay. If you chose card number 2, we have 2 cards here, and it's about emotionally moving on from this masculine air sign. So Aquarius, Libra, Gemini, it's time to just emotionally put that wall up, cut the energetic cords. You know, I talk to a lot of clients and I'll say, well, have you moved on from them? And they'll be like, well, it was a long time ago, or yeah, I don't think about them anymore, or yeah, I've moved on. These 3 factors are all great, but it's not energetically severing ties with this person by doing, you know, a past life hypnosis and figuring out, or past life reading and figuring out what your connection was, and saying, now that I've consciously become aware of why we're in each other's lives, I can energetically let go. Or if it's a cord cutting ceremony, you know, writing a letter to them, then burning it, flushing it down the toilet, and having that ceremonial kind of funeral for your relationship, saying, okay, I'm done now. Time doesn't really matter, right? It doesn't matter how much time has been passed. This could be, you know, your first ex, and it's like, well, it's been 20 years. Does not matter energetically. You want to do those aura cutting, those energetic cord cuttings, to finally move on and not look back in anger, in pain, in whatever, just fully letting go and moving on, okay? If you chose card number 3, we have 4 cards here. We've got a lot going on for you guys this week, December 7th to the 14th. A soulmate connection is only coming in just because you're straight up bored at home. So it's like, let me bring in this soulmate connection just to kind of give me some fun and excitement. But that's going to make you realize, like, what did I do? Why did I invest all this time and energy out of straight boredom? And what they're going to do is make you realize how much you've deceived yourself through that boredom, through that just saying something's missing at home, so I'm going to bring in this soulmate relationship. You end up playing yourself, right? It's all about being okay and being secure within yourself, especially at home. That's your domain. That's your environment. If you're not feeling empowered at home, if you're not feeling excited and energized, regardless of the pandemic, Just bringing in whatever's going to give you that sense of joy and that sense of peace and that sense of security without it being a soulmate connection that now brings in a whole level of karma. So if you're bored at home, don't do it. Don't bring in a soulmate energy. Instead, manifest something exciting, a possibility to take another risk that isn't just going to make you feel like you deceived yourself by investing time and energy into this play thing. That's really what it is. You're bored, so you're using your imagination to just play with this relationship, and it's not going to end well, okay? As always, if you guys want a personalized reading to kick off your 2021 energy, send me a message. I'm beyondyoursunsign@gmail.com, or you can reach me through here, through Instagram, through YouTube, whatever you got to do. I'm here to help. Love you guys so much, and I will see you next week. Bye.